warm heart of Africa contains many treasures. One of its most precious is Lake Malaŵi, a body of water so large that it resembles an inland freshwater sea. Deeper than half a mile at one point, it fills a widening crack in the Earth's crust, which is slowly splitting eastern Africa from the rest of the continent. While the afternoon sun sinks, brilliantly colored cichlids guard their territories and graze on algae that coats the rock surfaces. Lake Malaŵi is famous among biologists and fish hobbyists alike because it contains more cichlid species than the total number of freshwater fish species living throughout the entire continent of North America. As night approaches, cichlids begin to descend to safer resting places. They are all too familiar with a nocturnal threat that will soon appear. When darkness falls, a curious predator emerges to snatch up lagging cichlids and to search among the rocks for those caught off guard in their trance-like state of sleep. Known as Chisembe in the Chichewa language that surrounds the lake, or as Cornish jacks in English, scientists have given them the name Mormyrops anguilloides. The Chisembe are members of the Mormyrid family, a group which local fishermen call the Samwa Moa, or those that can't drink beer, on account of their unimpressively small mouths. The Samwa Moa represent a successful modern offshoot of an ancient group of fishes that has persisted since dinosaurs dominated the prehistoric landscape. At first glance, the Chisembe's hunting style appears slow and clumsy. The secret to their success is a special detection and communication system that doesn't utilize any of the five traditional senses. Instead, each Chisembe generates its own electric field. Rather than muscle, the cylindrical part of the tail contains a battery-like organ that continuously produces electric pulses. Each pulse establishes a short-range electric field, which Chisembe detect with extremely sensitive electroreceptors in their skin. The electric pulses can be recorded in real time using an electrode and amplifier, and then played back as audible clicks. What you are watching is the first video of electric fish behavior to ever be made in the wild in conjunction with simultaneous electrical recordings. When an object, a potential meal for example, enters a Chisembe's field, it causes a distortion analogous to an electrical shadow that can be detected on the skin. The pulses produced by the Chisembe, as well as those produced by hundreds of other Mormyrid species across Africa, aren't the powerful electric shocks like those made famous by South America's electric eel. Instead, they are extremely weak and cannot be detected by the cichlids they hunt. Chisembe often hunt in packs, gaining an advantage from the chaotic scramble of startled cichlids. Like echolocating bats, these electrolocating fish increase their pulse rate as they probe potential meals. Chisembe also communicate with one another. When members of the same pack meet, they modify the tempo of their pulses into brief synchronized bursts. Their bellies full, not with the traditional beer brewed in the villages around the lake, but rather with the night's catch of fresh fish, the Chisembe return to their cave before sunrise. The next morning, the lake's colorful inhabitants resume their daytime activities. A few territories now lie vacant for younger cichlids ready to continue life's rhythm in the turquoise waters of Lake Malaŵi.